hope you all are fine. I'm Anisha and welcome back to favorite YouTube channel Level of Fun. Now I know that probably for few hours or few days you might have experienced unstable internet or no internet or slow connection once at any stage of your life. And at that time, most of the people think that restarting their home Wi-Fi router or home Wi-Fi router will solve this problem. But in most of the cases, it actually doesn't work. But do you know why it doesn't work? Actually, the Wi-Fi router is not faulty. There is something faulty which is miles away from your house, and it's at the depth of the sea. Yeah, you guessed it right. That's the subsea cables or the submarine cables. And our today's video is also based on the subsea cables only. But now you might think that everybody knows about the subsea cable, then why did you make a video? Actually, there are some details which most of the people don't know. So in this video, we are going to discuss about the points like what are actually subsea cables, what is the history of subsea cables, who maintains and makes the subsea cables, and why are they important. So guys, without wasting any time, let's get started. Now guys, first let's discuss about what are subsea cables. As the name suggests, subsea cables or the submarine cables are the cables which are on the seabed and are made up of hundreds of small strands of wires. And now whenever you make a phone call over sea, do an email, or even download or upload a video to YouTube, you are transferring data, right? And when you transfer a data, we all know that a medium is required. And that is only, and the medium is none other than the subsea cables. It just does the work of transferring bytes of data from one place to the another place. That's the work. Now friends, if we talk about the history of the subsea cables, then the first subsea cable was installed about 150 years ago in 1858 from British to US. And it was installed so that Queen Victoria can communicate with the presidents and the government of US. And the message which was sent from Queen Victoria took about 16 hours to reach US, and the subsea cable was destroyed in just lesser a month. But that invention was a very big change for the world, that how the world communicates. And now if we fast forward 100 years from that time, now almost all the continents are connected with the subsea cables. Now the third point is of the who makes and maintains this subsea cables. Now from 20th to 21st century, all the subsea cables were made and owned by telecommunication companies. But now, many tech giants like Google, Facebook, Amazon, Microsoft even own many subsea cables around the world. And these tech giants talk with the government to maintain and upgrade these subsea cables time to time. And I can just tell you that these subsea cables are as important to these companies as their data center. And now if we talk about the about how these subsea cables are laid, then actually that's a little dangerous, okay? Actually, whenever these wires are laid on the seabed, they are first attached to a special ship and then it is laid to the seabed. Now, I know that it seems very normal, nothing too much hard, but that's not the case. Actually, when they plan the route of these wires, that's the main problem, because at the time of planning the route, they have to acknowledge many things like what is the climate of that area, what is the temperature, or is this area interrupted by fishing boats, or will it disturb the military action or anything else. Now guys, you might have a question that what if these subsea cables broke, then how will the work goes on? How the work goes on? How is the data transferred? So the answer to this question is there is a backup cable. With the original cable, there is even a backup cable which can be used to transfer the traffic data when the original cable is under fixing. That's the solution. Now the durability of a subsea cable is 25 years, but in the unpredictable conditions of the sea, mistakes can happen. And if a subsea cable ever breaks, then it's a very lengthy process to make it. First, the engineers have to locate the damaged area with an advanced underwater technology. And then a ship is sent, means a repair ship is sent to that area, and the broken subsea cable is then replaced with a new fiber cable. That's the process. Now our last point is about why are subsea cables important. Now I know a thing that most of you will already know that why they are important, because texting, seeing any video or phone calling, almost everything which you do from the internet is done by the subsea cables. Then you can just understand that internet is equal to subsea cables. Like that you can understand. Means whole internet is subsea cables. That's the importance. Now guys, that's all the information about the subsea cables. And as the world continues to spend their time online, the demand of the subsea cables will only increase. And the next time when you experience slow internet, then be patient. The technicians are doing their best. And with these lines only, I would like to end this video. So if you have liked this amazing topic, then give us a like and subscribe our channel. And for proper updates, press the bell icon as well. And give your valuable comments in the comment section. So it's all for today. Till then, goodbye.